Rita Fault is a fault zone that runs along the base of the Santa Rita Mountains south of Tucson. Those of the Tucson residents know that well. There's neat hiking and recreation in the Santa Rita Mountains. It runs basically from the northern end of the mountains all the way down down towards Mexico, past Green Valley and Suavita.
Here in Tucson, we're in the Basin and Range province, and there tend to be a lot of faults. Most of them are active very infrequently, but they have the potential to rupture, and they have the potential to rupture at a magnitude 6 or even a magnitude 7. So they can generate a really large earthquake. In 1887, we had a magnitude 7.5 just south of Douglas, Arizona, and it rattled the Tucson area pretty well. Didn't knock down any buildings, but it did cause some rock avalanches in the Santa Catalina Mountains, and also disturbed a lot of people, and people had trouble standing on their feet.
In Tucson, the damage was much more minor, but there was damage to, for example, the San Javier Mission on the south side of Tucson had some cracking of its bell tower in the earthquake. So the effects of it were felt widely across this region. And obviously, if it happened today, the damage would be far greater. The 1887 earthquake is really important for earth scientists to study these sort of events because it's the example. It's almost the worst case example, maybe. But then there's a really large earthquake in an area where there really isn't that much ongoing historical seismicity. So it illustrates the fact that these faults, like that fault and the Santa Rita Fault as well, can rupture and do rupture in large earthquakes. They just don't rupture very frequently. We're standing at the base of the fault scarp formed by the most recent large earthquake that occurred on the Santa Rita Fault. I'm near the base of it right here, and Lee is standing at about the top of this thing that we call a fault scarp. That's the feature that forms when in the case of a normal faulting event in the basin and range like this, the valley, which is towards the camera and behind us, drops down in a large earthquake, and the area closer to the mountains lifts up relative to the valley. So there's displacement across the fault zone, kind of like this. When this initially happens, it's a very sharp feature in the landscape, close to vertical, but over time, as it erodes away, it becomes more and more subtle, and now we're looking at something that is detectable but not as obvious. Geologists who study earthquakes and paleoearthquakes, earthquakes that occur before the recorded historical period, we use a variety of evidence to figure out whether a fault is active recently enough to be a concern seismic hazard-wise. And this fault scarp behind me is an example of that kind of evidence where we know that we're confident that a large earthquake occurred because of this impact that it made on the landscape, and we can still see the evidence, even though it may have been 50,000 years since this earthquake occurred. It was a large earthquake, it made an obvious imprint on the landscape, and we can still find evidence for that a long time afterwards.
As one of our efforts to inform the Arizona public, we host the Natural Hazards in Arizona Viewer. It's an online interactive map. It showcases where historic earthquake epicenters have occurred. It also shows where active faults are in Arizona. And there's been over 3,500 earthquake events historically in the state. And each one of those is recorded on that interactive map. People can come in and take a look at it. We have a lot of information about what people can do to prepare in this text called Arizona is Earthquake Country. It's free, it's online. Anyone is available. It's available to all people. And please take a look at it. It has lots of information about what you can do here in the southwestern part of the country to prepare for earthquakes.